Season 9, Episodes 1 to 4, titled Day of the Daleks. And of course, this is the beginning of Season 9 of the classic series, and it is the third season of the Third Doctor. Now, it's quite interesting because, like, okay, the First Doctor, you can borrow braggarts knowing it's the First Doctor. They didn't know the show was going to last for 60 years, and the and they didn't know that the Nazi teapots known as Daleks were going to be a thing. They didn't know they were going to be the big bads. They didn't know that, right? So they showed up in the second story. Have you? But they show up in the first story of the Second Doctor. And for the Third Doctor, it took them literally 2 to 3 seasons to have that happen. It's great. My guess, the idea is like, hey, drawn it out. Don't let them just like, boom, here's the Daleks. Next people wait for the Daleks. Let the audience breathe and experience new creatures and all that. Versus now where it's like, we have this contract that needs to happen that, you know, the Daleks need to show up every season, so they're going to show up at least every season. I mean, they don't need to be that long of a thing. Clearly, they just need to wave and go, you know, go the main day. They just need to appear at something. But it's just one of those quite interesting things where it's just like, they just drawn the Daleks out, and this is the first time we're having this version of the Doctor meeting the big bads. But here's the thing, for this four-part story, this is well-paced. This is a well-paced story where you have, like, the constant thing I've been saying, even the stories I like, is that it's an episode or two too long or an episode or two too short. But for this case, for Day of the Daleks, this is where we're put together. Now, the story is that there's this box and people are disappearing. It's a time-traveling machine. And people are just naturally playing with it. And people are disappearing, and they're getting traveled to 200 years into the future, and they're getting killed off by these gorilla creatures. I mean, clearly someone's all playing the apes and be like, let's have that. But these queer creatures are in charge of humans whose bosses are the Daleks. And, you know, you're hearing tropes that we have seen 1,000 times with the Daleks, where you have the Doctor saying, like, the Daleks are the most horrible creatures of all in space and time and all that. And that, which I would like, the scene in the story that is basically that the Doctor basically said the Daleks are bots and creatures and give a shit about you, that whole thing. That version of that in this story is really well put together. I was really drawn towards it. But you get the scene where the humans think the Daleks are the good guys, and the Doctor breaks the reality. There's a little bit of throwback to that reality. The human bad guys find out, realizes that's the truth, and the Daleks kill them off. We see that 1,000 times. It's all about how you tell it, right? And different versions of it. Now, this story, as I said, has really well put pace elements towards it. They do the comedy thing, and I think one of the complaints I have is, like, because it's meant to be 200 years in the future, and they're doing a bit of Back to the Future, where, like, something happened in the present that's leading to this apocalyptic future. But the problem is this apocalyptic future, outside of the place where the Daleks are at, there's not really much of a difference. I mean, it's a field and a car park. I mean, literally, there's a battle between these, like, these freedom fighters and the Daleks. And I'm like, clearly, you shot this, you know, this action sequence, this shootout, in a car park. In an empty car park at, like, you know, 9 o'clock in the, you know, on a Sunday night when no one's around. Like, I was like, this is a bit, anything to, like, there's not much of a difference. So, sometimes when we jump to time, you know, it got a little bit like, wait, are we in present day? Are we not in present day? I know where Joe and the Doctor are, but, you know, all the other characters, I kind of need to be, you know, you wish that it was a little bit more a little bit more recognizable, say, hey, this is this time period, this is that time period. But this is, it's put together. I mean, the Daleks are kind of side quests a little bit. Like, they don't show up a lot. They kind of show up, like, once every couple. Like, they have, like, two scenes per episode. And also, this is more like a whiter than me, and that is, have the Daleks be a mystery. But you can't really call it a mystery because they're in the title of the damn story. But I would literally have them show up for the first time at the end of episode 2. As the first time the Doctor meets them, that's when the audience meets them. That's personally how I would do it. Thumbs up for me with the story. I quite like it. Now, the next one on the list, the next one is Curse of the Bantons. And that is episodes 5 to 8. And see you guys a little bit later. Comment below if you've seen the story, what you think of this story.